Did you know that your walking speed can predict the likelihood of being hospitalized? And it is such an important measure of your body's function that it's been called a vital sign? I'm Will Riddick, and in our first walk talk, we're covering walking speed and what it means for your health. Walking is amazing. And our bodies are able to walk for miles and do so at an extremely efficient rate. And most people walk between 2.7 and 3.1 miles per hour. And while that seems slow compared to modern day vehicles, we're able to maintain that pace for a long time. We're actually able to cover long distances better than most other mammals on Earth. We're like well-oiled, high-performance machines when it comes to walking. Automobiles are typically designed to be most efficient at highway speeds, around 55 miles per hour, and we too have an internally set most efficient speed. To see this, all we need to do is to look at a graph comparing walking and the energy needed to cover a certain distance, such as this one. When we find the walking speed with the least energy needed, we find our most efficient walking speed. On this graph, it's about here. And this speed has been found to be about 3 miles per hour for most people. It's no coincidence that this is exactly in the ballpark of usual human speeds. Unfortunately, walking does not always go well, and any problem in walking will significantly impact this speed. As such, this makes walking speed an indicator of a person's physical capability. In a 2009 study called Walking Speed, the Sixth Vital Sign, researchers pulled together a collection of data showing the implications of a reduced walking speed. For those walking slower than 1.3 miles per hour, there is an increased risk for incidents requiring hospitalization. Now compare that to walking faster than 2.2 miles per hour, which actually reduced the risk for hospitalization. And speeds greater than 2.2 miles per hour were also correlated to greater independence in daily function and walking. That makes this speed an excellent goal to achieve. So, how do you check your speed? All you need is a tape measure, 2 small items to mark a distance, a stopwatch, and a calculator. Measure a 20-foot distance on the ground and place 2 objects on the ground to mark each end. Pins can work for this purpose. Then walk comfortably between the 2 marks, starting a little behind the first pin and walking past the second one. You start the timer when you cross the first pin and stop it when you cross the second. To calculate your speed in miles per hour, divide 13.64 by the time it took you to cover the 20-foot distance. This is your walking speed. What do you do if yours is slow? Reach out to your doctor about participating in physical therapy for your walking. There are many things that can be done to help restore your efficiency and speed, from exercises to intensive walking retraining. Walking speed says a lot about you. Make sure it says something good. Thanks for watching our first episode of Walk Talk. In our next episode, we're going to talk about tripping and catching your foot when you walk, so be on the lookout for that video. If you're new to Mission Gait, check out our website at missiongait.org. And to see more of these videos, you can either click the link in the corner to subscribe, or you can visit our YouTube channel at youtube.com/missiongait. So you know it. Two small items to mark a distance.